Oh my gosh, howdy, 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 folks. It's like 2 days in a row, like go 3-4 months without a video on Facebook, and then 2 days in a row, spoiling myself. All right, so I want to talk about a question I got asked, and I'm going to read this question. It's about, you know, should you quit your full-time job? Let's say you found the vending business, or you saw the potential in it, or you met a vendor, or you ate at a vendor and talked to them, and you were like, oh man, this is up my alley. It's what I want to do, but I have a good job. And even though maybe you don't like the job, it's your source of income. It's your primary source of paying the bills and keeping the refrigerator with stuff that needs cold, right? So here's the question I got, and I'm going to read this to you. It says, hey, Ben, I'm a school nurse, and lately I've been kind of obsessed with your videos and the idea of vending whole food plant-based F&B. Not sure what F&B is, but it's something to do with food-based plants, all right? So I have a long history in the food industry, but my family and I think I should keep my day job until I get established in anything else. Any videos or advice on when to quit your day job and how to be extra successful selling in, and she mentions her area. I'm not going to divulge that. Your videos have been giving me loads of ideas and tips so far. I've got the summer off, so I thought I might keep doing my due diligence in the meantime. Thanks so much. Now, I got this Sunday at 3:09 p.m. So maybe school's still out there. Maybe she's a school nurse at a non-public school. I thought the public schools were all in now. Thanks so much for all your time and attention and consideration of others. Soon I plan to join the Vendors United group. Before I buy one of your carts, come to think of it, they could probably answer those questions for me along with any others I'll have in the future, huh? Well, true. And you, Vendors United is a great place for resourcing directly with vendors. It's a small group. You know, there's about 200 people in there who are vending. Some are about 40 something of them are not vending yet. Most are vending. And you can ask questions and get answers immediately. There's always people there helping each other, and it's all kept private. Okay. So they'll actually spill their guts and give you good advice. So, this is a great question. It's a great question. And I've covered this before on, learnhotdogs.com, but maybe not, you know, maybe it was part of another video and somebody asked the question and I covered it that way. I've never So, and I'm not saying everybody's job is just over broke, but obviously they wouldn't be looking at something else if they were 100% completely happy with what they had. And I get that. I get that. So here's what I think, and I would advise. This is my two cents on this, okay? My two cents on let's say you have a job, and let's say you have a family, or even if you don't have a family to support, you're supporting yourself at the very minimum, right? And so I would never advise anybody to just go, hey guys, found hot dog vending, see ya, and put in your 2 weeks notice. I wouldn't do that. I think that would be adding additional risk to you without a reason. There's not a valid reason to do that. Now, I've done videos and I've done blog articles on when to start, the best time to start a vending business, anytime, right now, today. The best time was about 5 years ago, maybe 10, but it's too late for that. It's like planting a tree. When's the best time? There's two times, you know, 20 years ago or today. So you can start whenever you want, but it doesn't mean quitting what you have that's going to support you. Now, here's what we run into. There's a negative here when you do that. A lot of people go into it and they overwhelm themselves. And so what I would advise is to not quit your job and to do this when you can. If that's 2 days a month, then great. We have a vendor in our group, Michael Wood, been vending. He kept his his job all the way up till this past, I think this year. And for 8 years, he worked about 3 days a month, made a real income, a full-time income, almost 3 days a month. But he quit his job later. Okay. And it was only because the job closed up. So the point is it adds a sense of security, and it adds real security to you if you stay in that job while you pursue this. I would say the very biggest mistake that many people make is they don't do their due diligence. This person is doing their due diligence. They're asking the questions. They're getting the information they need before they step into it. I would, if I was this nurse, start vending part-time. I'd start vending part-time once a week, twice a week, you know, maybe a night shift at a bar on the weekends, maybe doing a couple events a month. You know, it's event season. The fall is fantastic for it. This vendor is in Florida, so it's, you know, vend all year round in the sunshine. But we have vendors vending all year round in Alaska, so it really doesn't matter. But the point is, it makes it easier. So that's what I would say to do, is to protect yourself and cause yourself less stress by keeping that job until you feel comfortable and secure. This has to be a decision that you make, though. It's your decision. It's not someone else's decision. You need to make that decision when it's time to transition full time into the business. Once that income is overpowering this one, then great. Now, we've got some vendors that still have, that work full time vending part time their old job, so they keep medical benefits, because, as you know, self-employed and being self-employed, you have to provide your own insurance, and that can be super expensive depending on the state you live in. But it's pretty much expensive across the board. That would be my 2 cents on it. Okay. Is don't quit and start this. Bam. All of a sudden, the only people that I see that are successful with that model are the ones that just know for a fact, I'm going to do this, get do or die. Or the ones that were forced into it. Those are the ones that, you know, they don't have a choice. It was like me. I didn't have a choice. I didn't like have a backup plan. I had vending, and that was it. I was broke, food stamps, and I go vend. And so I went and vended. I didn't have a job to fall back on. So that's what I would say there. I'm going to run through some of the comments real quick, and I thank y'all for being here. Dub Down Dogs is in the house. Glad to see you. Look at there. Life gave us lemons and catering. Love that. I love that name every time I see it. Matt's in the house. Thanks for being here, Matt. Let's see. Not been here in a while. Was dealing with some bad times, but working through it to get back on track. Hot Dogs. John Doon, thanks for being here. I'm more power to you, brother. We all face things. You know, I shared some stuff last night in the private group that, you know, my wife goes, why'd you share that? That's personal information. Why would you tell people that? And we all go through struggles and trials and tribulations, and sometimes it helps to have a sounding board, or at least have people to listen that give a crap. So I'm behind you, John. Love you. Todd, Toby, Henning, John, Heidi, Raines, Casey. There you go. The dream. Luke says, long time no see. I know. I was here yesterday, though. You missed it. Glad you are here. Garrett says, hi, lads. We at Monster Burgers Dublin are going to do a 3-month total upgrade on the business. We would love your input. Garrett, I will share whatever input you want. Maybe you and I could do a live interview, and I could bring you in, and you could get people caught up. In fact, I could add you to this right now if you want to. I have a way to do that. I can send you a link real quick, and you can come right in here live with me. Share your plans. We're happy to help. Don't be a meanie. Buy yourself a weenie. Reminds me of Mustard's Last Stand. I went and videoed years ago in Champaign, Illinois. He's passed away now, but he was 73 vending, had 4 carts out. 3 of them were mine, and one was his first cart, and he had been vending longer than I had been alive at the time. And he made a killing. I mean, when I was there and I filmed this, the bread truck pulls up to one of the carts, just one, and sets out 1,000 buns in a rack, all these stackable, you know, bread trays, and stacks them up next to his cart. It was the best thing. And that was one of his sayings. Don't be a meanie, eat a weenie. I found my dream truck. It's every penny I've saved, afraid to spend it. So they gave me half now, half come spring. Oh my God, that shite is getting real. I know that feeling. You know what? That's some of the best motivation for an entrepreneur is just to take that step, to take that step and know that there's no turning back now. I've bought it now, baby. I've got to do this. I don't want no shiny piece of yard art. Or I could think of other things to buy with $3,000 to $5,000 or $10,000 or whatever you spend, right? Than to make shiny new pieces of yard art. You got to use that cart and you got to make money with it. And it's doable. That's what's so cool about this business is it's freaking doable. It's doable for everybody. It's not like, oh, you got to be lucky, you know? Let's see, Dubtown. Let's see, Big Boss Dogs in the house. Thanks for being here. Rick says, quit my job last week. Thanks to the confidence you gave me. Rick, dude, street food and catering, baby. Love it. Love it, Rick. And I love that you put catering. Love it. Garrett says, give me five. Garrett may come on here. If y'all hang around, Garrett may actually join us here. That'd be freaking cool as heck, wouldn't it? Garrett, I'm going to give you a link here. In fact, I think I have to put it actually in this. And then I'm going to put it in the comments and you can join me if you so choose. I'm not putting any pressure, no pressure. Okay. I think you should see it. I don't see it. I just added it, but I don't see it anywhere. Oh, there it is. So, thanks for being here. Loving these vids, Matthew. Thank you a bunch. I love doing this. Believe it or not, I got almost caught up today on emails. I just have today's emails to do. I got caught up on yesterday's emails today, so which is good for me. Those on the fence, join Vendors United. If I feel as if I took a shortcut to my business, thank you for saying that. Vendors United is a huge, huge deal. It's the best thing in the world, and I'm biased for obvious reasons, right? But I'm telling you, if you get in there and you try that, you'll go, oh my gosh, at the help. Oh my gosh, at the tips, stuff you won't find anywhere. Vendors there sharing, vendors that are a week in, vendors that have been doing it 10 years, vendors that have been doing it 20 years. There are so many, and people from all kinds of backgrounds, truck drivers, police officers. We got one guy in there, Secret Service, actually sent me his Secret Service badge, okay, for the president, you know, his presidential Secret Service badge. We've got so many cool people in there, chiropractors in there. I think there's two or three. There's people that have been at the lowest part of life, made some horrible decisions out of prison. They're there that worked at Waffle House 18 years. And now they own their own business. You would be amazed at what's there. You can find out more about that at learnhotdogs.com/join. If you are, though, I've got a little scrolly thing going on the bottom of the screen. And if you are either already in the business or wanting to get started, I've got something there for you. It's just kind of like a wizard. It'll guide you where you need to go. Let's see, those on the fence going, okay. I think we're good. I'm going to see, wait and see just for a second. Bear with me. If, let's see, he says, folks think what he does on YouTube times 100 Vendors United. I'm not a paid spokesman. Some of my boy that needed the help. Thank you for that, brother. Thank you. Yeah, he's not a paid spokesman or he wasn't planted or seeded in this group. It's valuable to a lot of people. It's valuable to me as well. Frank says, hi, Ben, just got my email confirmation for Tallahassee. I'm getting close to being legal. Thank goodness. Congratulations, Frank. That's freaking awesome. I've got some interviews scheduled. I'm trying to set one up now for tomorrow with Jennifer. Wait till y'all meet Jennifer. I'll probably do that interview. I'll probably post it here and on YouTube. But that interview is, I'm excited for it. This lady has been through hell and back, and single mom, and just a 100% badass. She's a never say never, never say quit, just bullheaded, full forced forward in life. And no matter, even after just doing good and something slander, you know, car tore up, lost this, lost, I mean, just horrible crap happened. She just comes right back and just bam, bam, bam. She's in Vendors United. So if you already in there, you already know this. She's just cool. And I want to share it with y'all. And she's agreed to share some stuff. So I think that'll be cool. I'm waiting. If you're wondering what I'm waiting on, that we have a vendor in Ireland that's often on here and on the YouTube with us, and I've never had him live or anything, but I'd love to hear from him and share what he's got. And I've sent him a link, and I'm gonna see if he can join me here. I've got a way to bring in a guest and split the screen. High-tech redneck stuff. I'd hate to explain it to you. It's really confusing. I'm just kidding. It's buttons. Let's see. Oh, we have to organize it. Garrett says we're going to have to organize it. There he is. I put the link here, Garrett. If you want to come into this, you can. You don't even have to use video if you don't want to. And I'll put it again for you, okay? Just look in the comments and you'll see it. If you want to organize something with me, that'd be great too. We can do that as well. I don't care. I know this was spur of the moment. And let's see. Here's a good question. And let me check one of this. I'm pulling this up. Okay. Marine says, bought one. One, everything was broken in it. Looking at a better one, they say I can see Frylay to work by them filling it with water. This time I want to see all the equipment actually work instead of buying more shiny yard art. And I actually have a video on this. If you go to learnhotdogs.com/used, the word used, learnhotdogs.com/used. I've got a video at the top of that page. It's a Facebook group. You have to ask to join. It keeps out the riffraff, the people that are just these bots that come in and advertise sunglasses and crap. So at the top, or just go to the YouTube page and type in used, you know, on our page, and you'll see the used. I've got an instructional thing that shows you how to check a cart completely before you buy it used. And it's not a negative video. In fact, I teach you that it's better to buy used at first, so you spend less, you can get in the black quicker. Let's see. Maureen says, I think I love you. I love you, Maureen. Thank you for the kind words. Your burners on the website fit an all-American cart. You may have to change the pipes, the fuel rail, for it to fit. You may have to change something. You may have to modify it. But I've got some free videos on the site. On the store that show you that you can make your own fuel rail. Okay. You can adapt ours to fit yours. There's things you can do. I don't know all the techie stuff about that, but it's doable. Let's see. John says, can pretzels be served on an open cart? Yes and no. Okay. How's that for an answer? In some states they can. It's 100% okay as long as they're like, I had a plastic thing, a plexiglass thing I built over the steam table with a rack in it and could do it that way. You can do a roll top and stack them and serve them individually. Some states, though, say absolutely no. Doesn't make any sense to me either, okay, because they allow you to serve your buns, not individually wrapped, but you can't serve a pretzel. So we have some vendors that are buying the wrapped pre-wrapped, pre-sealed pretzels and keeping them in the steam table, heating them up there, and then letting the customer open them up and giving them the single serve portion cups, portion control cups, they call them, that are single serve. You open them up with different sauces, right? And that's, I just did an article updating that on the blog on the pretzels, and I sent out an email to everybody there. Let's see. Scott says, have had a cart for several years now and still not gotten it up and running. Pensacola, Florida. Okay, before I answer or say anything about the Scott, let me say this about the last question about the pretzels. Call the health department first and ask them, because you may not have to do nothing with pretzels. Okay, call them and ask them and go, hey, can I serve pretzels? They're, you know, I buy them and can I serve pretzels? I don't cook them, I just heat them up. They call that re-thermalize. If you want to use that word, re-thermalize, they'll think you're high-tech and you're cool and you know the codes. Several years now, haven't gotten up and running. What's your hold up, Scott? I know that feeling. I know that feeling where you know, I've talked to vendors that had either got given a card or got, you know, passed down something or found a good deal and thought maybe I'm going to do it. Think about maybe doing it part-time and getting going. Or make yourself a commitment. And within a week, I'm going to have all my licensing. Within 2 weeks, I'm going to have this. And maybe go into it just as a caterer. Okay? And I teach you that that's not the normal catering like you see at a catering company. It's so cool. Drop-off catering. Go check that out at learnhotdogs.com. And maybe the lady that asked me from Florida about going part-time, that's another great way to get into the business, is using the catering method. And it's easier, quicker, and often quicker to get licensed and cheaper to get licensed, and a great way to do it part-time and still make a full-time income. I have some articles at learnhotdogs.com on working part-time and still making a full-time income. If you go to learnhotdogs.com and just type in the word part-time, and you'll have it. Maureen says, so buy the book and read chapter 4, or did I use the wrong link to learn how to buy a used cart? No, that's great. That information there. I've probably expanded on it in the video. I've got a 2-part video, which I'm long winded anyway. It probably could be condensed, you know, by 90%, you know what? I'll put the link here. Can y'all bear with me just a second? Let's see. Used. Yeah, I got part 1 and part 2 right here for you. Check this out. You didn't make a bad decision. And I even teach in this that you can, Maureen, you can fix anything. And sometimes it's cheaper just to fix it. Like if you had to gut the whole cart and start over, it'd be cheaper than buying a new one. Okay. So, and I teach you how to do that. As far as I tell you what to do, you can take it to a steel fabrication shop and tell them exactly what you want done. Or you can save a ton of money if you have the know-how or the want to, I guess the want how to do it yourself, you can. But I'm not that kind of person. I'm not but here's the link. I'll put it in here in the comments. Let's see. Law and getting it. Oh, Scott says law and getting it legal is what's been the holdup for him, getting the laws around it and getting it legal. I walk you step by step. Literally, if you're in Florida, it's pretty quick. I mean, you can literally be up and running within a few days in Florida. Florida, you can submit it online and then they'll come out to see the cart at your house even and then sign off. And then in the mail, you'll get your official license, but they'll sign off and give you permission to start vending. You're welcome, Maureen. Just bought my first used cart, going to upgrade to the big dog when I start making some money. Ryan, let that first cart buy your next cart, your next cart, your next cart. Let it make the money. Let it pay for it. Let's see. I'm sorry, I've tried all the buttons on this live. After you're done, message me on Facebook. Garrett, I'm sorry it didn't work. It's just a link in here, in the comments, and you click that link and it's supposed to let you join the show. John says, what about Missouri? I think that's about the pretzels. I don't know for a fact. I don't know. Just call your local health department and ask them. I believe you can. I think we have a vendor. I'm pretty sure you can in Missouri. We have vendors doing lobster rolls in Missouri. In fact, it was the saving grace sandwich for John Kavanaugh, who struggled for a year and then introduced that and made several thousand dollars his first weekend at a farmer's market. We have all that on video, and he's been on the show for years. He's since passed away. He got cancer. But we have all that stuff and those shows and those videos and everything on the blog. Garrett says, I miss this show. Hey, Garrett, I've been doing it on YouTube, brother. That's where I've been doing most of them. Scott, you're welcome. Look at there, Mark Lawler in the house, the Great American Hot Dog Stand. If you aren't following him, how would you like to check this out? I just want to mention this, okay? What if you wanted to go and work with a vendor, a real vendor, for a day? Okay. It'd be a challenge. There's some vendors that are charging for that. Some charge as much as $1,500 because they feel like they're kind of creating their own competition. And some of them just, it's a pain in the neck because it requires time. Well, Mark, who owns Great American Hot Dog Stand, is in Alabama. He's one of the vendors that has agreed and has helps us out to train people. And it's free. You go for free. Just get yourself there. And you can set that up by going to learnhotdogs.com/best day ever. I'm going to type that in. Okay. learnhotdogs.com/best day ever. Okay. I just typed that in, and that will give you a great, insight into the business. If you want hands-on experience, the ins and outs, Mark's going to shoot you straight. Nothing to buy there except maybe your lunch. It's just an awesome deal. And I've been fortunate enough to have people, friends like Mark, that will allow you to come do that. It's on a schedule basis. So don't message him on here, and go, hey, I want to come. Just go to that link. And it's got a calendar, and you set it up that way. Let's see. There is money back in the business, and it's time we all make some money, some big money on gourmet products. Garrett, there is a lot of money in the business. In fact, I did an article on how to turn your $2 hot dog into a $7 hot dog. It's over on the blog. I just did it this past weekend, learnhotdogs.com. You'll see it near the top. But you're exactly right. This vendor, he put craft paper around his hot dogs and some string. It looked sexy as heck, and it worked. He made more money. And Mark says, the Great American Hot Dog Stand says, and I'll feed you if you work hard. So it ain't gonna cost you nothing. Just get there. Maybe an idea for you if you're just thinking about getting in the business and you want some training, some hands-on, you know, feel what this feels like to be a vendor. Mark is a fantastic, he's a street food pro. He's an awesome guy. And came from radio. Okay. Just, you're going to love it. You're going to love it. It's an awesome experience. I hope this helps you. I'm going to go. I know I ran long, and I'll come back later. We'll talk soon. Hope that helps everybody. Love you.